I want to let people know, in order to make this Canopus ADVC110 work with the new Mac or Apple products in general, you do need to buy some hardware. This is basically a Thunderbolt 2 port connector on this end. On the other end, it's FireWire 800. You can then get an adapter to go from FireWire 800 to FireWire 400. It's the FireWire 400 port that the FireWire cable will connect into. Now, some of you might be thinking, since this is FireWire 800, do you need this FireWire 400 to 800 adapter? You don't need it. You could just get a cable that goes from FireWire 400 to FireWire 800. That would work as well. I just wanted to see if these adapters would still supply power to the Canopus ADVC110. It did work out, so I was just kind of curious. That's why I went this route. But you don't really need the adapter, you could just get the cable itself. When everything is said and done, all the adapters and cables should connect just like this. This Thunderbolt 2 adapter to FireWire 800 will obviously plug into the Thunderbolt 2 port on my Mac Mini. If you have a Thunderbolt 3 port on your laptop or your Mac Mini, you would just have to purchase an additional Thunderbolt 3 to Thunderbolt 2 adapter. For this particular video, we're good to go with the way things are set up right now. Also, we need to take the RCA cables from the VHS deck and plug them into the input of the ADVC110. For this particular demo, I'm going to take the RCA out of the Canopus ADVC110 and plug it into this broadcast compliant monitor. This will allow us to see what we're capturing on this big, broadcast compliant monitor. I am now going to capture the VHS tape using Adobe Premiere Pro. Before I try and capture the VHS tape, I want to make sure that the VCR is powered on. I also want to make sure that the ADVC110 is set to analog in. I'm going to select that now. If I hit play on the VCR, we see that it plays out to the broadcast compliant monitor. That's exactly what I want to happen. In Premiere Pro, I simply go over to the menu bar where it says File. I simply scroll down to Capture. This will bring up the Premiere Pro Capture utility. If I go over to Settings, we see that it says Browse. This will allow you to select what folder you want to capture the audio and video into. I'm not really going to worry about that right now. What I do want to worry about is where this Edit option is. Where it says HDV, I need to select DV. If I select OK, now we see what's on the broadcast compliant monitor is outputting to the graphic user interface of Premiere Pro. We have options here. These aren't really going to be of any use to us because we're not going to have DAC control or anything like this with this simple DV converter. We can't fast forward or rewind. You might want to make sure that this is set up properly too. This is set up for my Canopus ADVC110. The ADVC100 works just great as an option. I'm going to select OK. All I'm going to do right now is select the record button, press it. Now we're recording. I don't need to record any more than about 10 seconds, so I'm going to hit stop really quick. We're going to select OK. There we see the video came up into our project. I'm going to hit record again. Like I said, I don't need a lot of, video. 10 seconds should be fine for the purpose of this demo. I'm going to select stop. I'm going to hit OK. It labeled it itself. I'm going to close this part of the graphic user interface out. Pretty simple. Now I can drop and drag these into this particular timeline, easy enough. And that really is all there is to it. I'm selecting this back to digital instead of analog. Now this is playing out the Premiere Pro timeline. So if I hit play, this is the timeline outputting to the NTSC monitor. The DV converters can do that. Let me drop this into the timeline as well so you'll see exactly what's going on. See, now it's playing this out to the broadcast compliant monitor. It's pretty easy using Adobe Premiere Pro. You just have to make sure you have it set up correctly. What I would do is I'd go where it says Premiere Pro. I want to go to Preferences, where it says Playback. You can see I got Adobe DV selected. There is some setup options. I don't think you really need to worry about it, so I'll hit Cancel, OK. But that's really all there is to output to the DV converter using Premiere Pro. A lot of people used to do this back like in 2003 and 2007.